Greensboro, North Carolina. How you doing out there tonight? I don't know if I'm convinced yet. I said, how you doing out there tonight, North Carolina? All right, all right, all right, much better. Listen, we are called for today. It is an honor, a privilege, and a blessing to be here with you guys. Thank you so much for coming out here today. I'm sure somebody's mentioned it before, but today is our last day on this tour. And you guys are absolutely incredible. Thank you so much for coming out and helping us end on a high note. How many of you have had a good time so far tonight on the Unshakeable Tour? Good. While we're at it, why don't you give it up for some friends of ours that were kind enough to join us in the band's 100th Texas in July Sleeping Giant and Impending Doom! Incredible bands full of good friends of ours. Make sure you go and check out all the merch for sale. Support these bands. Keep them doing what they're doing. And in case you didn't notice, there's a booth set up back there for an organization called World Vision. It was kind enough to partner with us on this tour. And those guys are involved in some really incredible stuff. And I know that you may think that you don't have what it takes to change the world because you're just a young adult from here in North Carolina. But I'll tell you, man, those guys are working on the political end to help bring an end to human trafficking. And if you get connected with them, you can legitimately be a part of saving somebody's life on the other side of the planet. That's a good deal. So listen, I had somebody ask me today, what were the craziest shows on this entire tour? And I said, I don't know, it was a tie between Lansing, Michigan and Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Greensboro, listen, I would love to tell people it was Greensboro, North Carolina, but y'all gotta earn it. So we still got a long way left to go. Are you guys tired out there yet? All right, Greensboro, then I want you to show me what you got left.
Yeah.
I'm impressed. Did anybody count? I lost that or no. That must have been at least 46,000 stage dives. Yo, everybody okay? Everybody survive? Raise your hand if you just died. Good, listen. So I come here, for those of you that maybe have never known the love of God, for those of you, even those of you that maybe grew up in church, but you've just been getting your brains kicked in by the devil, even just getting your brains kicked in by the media, even getting your brains kicked in by the broken and flawed system of darkness that this world has submitted to. You feel like you're losing, like you're overwhelmed and outnumbered, like you're surrounded by the enemies of darkness. You've been begging and pleading, saying, God, where are you? How am I ever going to get through this? How am I ever going to get out of this? Listen, if that's you, would you raise your hand right now? If you've been calling yourself a Christian for years, if that's you, if you feel outnumbered by hell, would you be bold enough to raise your hand?
Every person in here.
Not every person in here. God bless you, but that's not. If that's not you, don't raise your hand. Keep your hand up if that for real is your heart. I have good news for you. That one man with God is the advantage. One man with God is the advantage. That's something Elijah could tell you. Stood face to face with 400 false prophets and was still victorious. That's something that every disciple could tell you. That every religious leader stood against what they were trying to do. That they were threatened. Their families were threatened. Many of them were murdered for refusing to deny the lordship of Jesus Christ. And every single one of them would tell you, if they were standing on the stage, that one man with God is the advantage. Listen, friend. The reality of the life we're living right now is this. That every victory has already been won by Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And anyone who would put their life in his hands can walk in joy and peace and hope in the fact that he has already won. So all I have to do is believe it and rest in his arms. So listen over this crowd right now. I just plead the blood of Jesus. God, I just plead the blood of Jesus. I say that no matter who you are, and this might mess with some people's theology, no matter who you are or what you believe, your sins are forgiven right now. That right now the blood of Jesus covers you. You're standing under the authority of the blood of Almighty Jesus. So I just declare and plead the blood of Jesus over you right now. And even beyond that, I just say that you're marked with the presence and the power of the living God. I say that your heart of stone is being removed, and he's putting a heart of flesh in you right now. He's taking out that the unclean, selfish, prideful, arrogant spirit that you've been operating in, and he's putting in you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, a spirit of insight, a spirit of power and of love. He's putting inside of you the spirit of the living God. He's giving you his character so that he can then entrust you with his power in the earth. I say that the atmosphere of heaven is going to follow you out of this building. It's going to begin to infect your school. It's going to begin to infect your workplace. It's going to begin to infect your bedroom and your house and your friends. It's not going to be able to, you're not going to be able to shake it off, man. That the presence of God is going to mark you right now. I say it's marking you right now, and you're never going to be the same. You're never going to be the same. Hallelujah. Listen, there are a lot of preachers that stand on stage and make empty promises to people, and I don't want to be one of those. It's easy for me to stand up here and say, you're never going to be the same. But if you leave here and you keep doing the same stuff, you will be the same. So let me set the record straight. I don't want to make some sort of promise out of flattery, trying to puff you up and make you believe something that's just not true. If you leave here and keep living the same life you were living, you're going to get exactly the same results. But if you leave here and you commit your every moment to Jesus, if you leave here and you arrange your schedule however you need to arrange it to seek him and to pursue him in the secret place, if you leave here with the courage to go lay your hands on the sick, I'll bet you'll start seeing them recover. If you leave here with the courage to go and tell people about the kingdom of God and the forgiveness and mercy that was made available in Jesus, I'll bet you they'll start getting saved, man. So I'm telling you, this is your invitation. This is your opportunity. This is your great commission to go forth and make disciples of all nations. Are you with it? Why is that way?
listless.